Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Welcome to Grace New Covenant Worship Center, located at 1643 Aberdeen Avenue, Columbus, Ohio, 43211, a cathedral in the heart of Linden. We want to welcome everyone that's with us on this morning, those of you that might be on your iPads or on your TV or wherever medium you use. We thank you so very much, and we'd like to welcome all of our friends from across the nation, from New York to California, that's in today. Thank you so very much. I know that you watch because you call me and tell me that you're watching and that you're following, so we praise God. And even for those, our friends that's here in the city of Columbus, thank you so very, very much. If you want to know more about our ministry, you can go to gncworship.org, and there you'll be able to see all the ministries that we have going forward. To the members of Grace New Covenant, if you have not been given your tithe and your offering, please do so. Some told me they was going to take care of it, but I need you to not tell me. I need you to do it, because bills still roll even though we're closed. Amen. So you can mail them to 1643 Aberdeen, or you can bring them by the church and put them in the side mailbox. Or you could go on the website and go under the giving tab and use your debit or credit card, and we'll get it right away. So thank you again. Please don't forget that we have prayer every Thursday and Friday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., and that's over the phone. And the Lord has certainly been blessing us, and our prayer requests have been, he's been answering. So we encourage you all to get involved in the prayer on Thursday and Friday. It's only 1 hour, 2 days a week. 1 hour, 2 days a week, and prayer means so much. Also, remember our Bible study every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Please join us on Facebook Live or either on Periscope. I would like to say that this is open enrollment for the School of Biblical Theology Seminary. Open enrollment begins now. Classes begin in July. And you can, again, go to the website, scroll down to the School of Biblical Theology Seminary, and it will list all the classes and the times, and you'll be able to sign up. You can sign up even on the internet, so you can go there and do that. But check us out. See what we're doing. We no longer have GNC Institute, but it's now the School of Biblical Theology Seminary. And if you're not a member but would love and feel unction by the Holy Ghost to contribute to this ministry, please go to the website. Please obey the Holy Ghost. Don't say it's the devil, because it ain't. It's not the devil that's going to tell you to give. Amen. That's not him. So it might be the devil to tell you don't do it, but it ain't the one that's telling you to do it. So go to the website, go to gncworship.org, and go to the giving tab and use your debit or credit card and give whatever the Lord has laid upon your heart. At this time, it's time for worship and praise. So we have Minister Steve Adams and Minister Jenny Price that's going to lead us in worship and praise. So let's receive them by saying amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. It is a great day to be in the kingdom. Amen. So we're going to ask that you come on and join in with us this morning, because we come to give God praise, amen? And even though we're still separated and apart, God is ever present, amen? This song says, our God is greater, our God is stronger, our God is higher than any other. Song goes like this. Oh, water you turn into wine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God is healer, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? What can stand against? What can stand against? What can stand against? Oh, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? What can stand against? What can stand against? What can stand against? Oh, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God.
Hallelujah. This morning, we thank God for being who He is. Amen. This song says this.
Our Father, all of heaven roars your name. Can't sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. Our Father, all of heaven roars your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. Our Father, all of heaven roars your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out. Heaven come down. Spirit break out. Break our walls down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. So King Jesus, your name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and sky. Revival, we wanna see your kingdom here. We wanna see your kingdom here. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and sky. Revival, we want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. Spirit break out. Break the walls down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. Spirit, we want your spirit. We want your spirit. We want your spirit. Come like a rushing wind. Come like never before. Come like a rushing wind. Come like never before. Come like a rushing wind. Come like never before. Come like a rushing wind. Come like never before. Don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you, don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Yes, I need you, yes, I need you, yes, I need you. Cause I need you, cause I need you, don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me, cause I need you. Come like a rushing wind, come like never before. Come like a rushing wind, come like never before. Come like a rushing wind, come like never before. Come like a rushing wind, come like never before. Don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you, don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you, cause I need you. Yes, I need you, cause I need you. Cause I need you in my heart. Yes, I need you in my mind, Lord. Cause I need you in my home. Yes, I need you. You know what's going on down here. Lord, I need you. Sickness all around us. Lord, we need you. Yes, I need you, cause I need you. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. Melt me, mold me, fill me. Cause I don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you, don't wanna move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you, cause I need you, cause I need you. Yes, I need you, yes, I need you. I'm never gonna let you go, Lord, cause I need you. like Jacob wrestled with the angel all night long. Lord, yes, I need you, cause I need you. Won't let you go till you bless me, Lord, cause I need you. I need you like a river needs water to get along. Lord, I need you like a tree needs the leaves. Lord, I need you. Yes, I need you. Yes, I need you. Cause I need you. Don't want to move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you. Don't want to move. I will stay here until you change me. Cause I need you. Cause I need you. Cause I need you. Cause I need you. Cause I need you.
We thank him for his mercy and for his love that he's rendered unto us even now. Hallelujah. Today, we do honor all of our elders and ministers and to all of our deacons. Again, we honor all of those that are watching and listening to us. We praise God for you, and we thank the Lord of the blessings that he's going to send your way. I pray that the Lord will send his blessings and that they will overtake you. You be walking down the street, and the blessings of the Lord will come and tackle you. You could be in your home, and the blessings of the Lord come and tackle you. That's what we believe in God for this morning. The blessings of the Lord. Hallelujah. Today we know where we need to get to. Not just sure whether it's 71, 77, 670, or 315. But we're going to get there. We're going to find our way. I'd like to call your attention to the book of Kings, chapter number 18. And beginning with verse number 20, where am I? Verse number 17. Verse number 17. Well, we're going to look at chapter number 18, verse number 17. Hallelujah. And it came to pass when Ahab saw Elijah, that he asked him, "Art thou he that troubleth Israel?" And he answered, "I have not troubled Israel, but thou and thy father's house. And that ye have forsaken the commandment of the Lord, and thou hast followed Baal. Now therefore send and gather to me all of Israel unto Mount Carmel, and the prophets of Baal 450, and the prophets of the grove 400, which eateth at Jezebel's table." So Ahab sent unto all of the children of Israel and gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, "How long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him." And the people answered him not a word. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask you to turn with me to 1 Kings, also chapter 19 and verse number 9. And he came hither unto a cave and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, "What doest thou here, Elijah?" For my subject, you can be seated. For my subject, I would like to use, "What are you doing here? What are you doing here?" When we look at Elijah stood up boldly for God in times when idolatry has swept his land. In fact, his name means "My God is Yahweh." The false god Elijah opposed was Baal, the favorite deity of Jezebel, wife of King Ahab of Israel. To please Jezebel, Ahab had ordered the altars erected to Baal, and the queen murdered God's prophets. So it was very dangerous to be a prophet. They weren't walking around saying, "I'm a prophet of God." No, because it was a dangerous occupation. Elijah appeared before King Ahab to announce God's curse. "And the Lord, the God of Israel, lives, whom I serve. There will be neither dew nor rain in the next 3 years, except by my word." So here we find that when we get to chapter 18, things are happening. There hasn't been any rain. So that's why Ahab asked him, "Are you the one that troubleth Israel?" And the prophet says, "I don't trouble Israel. You trouble Israel and your father's house for not keeping his commandments." Then Elijah fled to the brook of Cherith, east of the river of Jordan, where ravens brought him bread and meat. When the brook dried up, God sent Elijah to live with a widow. And God performed another miracle there, blessing the widow's oil and flour so she wouldn't run out. Unexpectedly, the widow's son died, and Elijah stretched himself over the body of the boy 3 times, and God restored the child's life. Confident of the power of God, Elijah challenged the 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of the false god to shut down Mount Carmel. The idolaters sacrificed a bull and cried out to Baal from morning to nightfall, even slashing their skin until blood flowed, but nothing happened. They was calling on him, and Elijah not only was looking at him, but he was laughing at him. He was saying, he was what we used to call signifying. He was saying, "Maybe your God is dead. Maybe he's asleep. Maybe he's on vacation. He don't hear you. Call him a little louder." Elijah then rebuilt the altar of the Lord, sacrificing the bull there. So the challenge that went out was this: whoever or whatever God answered by fire, let him be declared God. So we know that it wasn't Baal. But he put the burnt offering on it. He rebuilt the altar and put the offering on it along with wood. He had his servants to douse the sacrifice and wood with 4 jars of water 3 times until it was thoroughly soaked. Elijah called on the Lord, and God's fire fell from heaven, consuming the offering, the wood, the altar, the water, and even the dust around it. Everything was soaked. And the people fell on their face shouting, "The Lord, he is God." Because he began to cry out. When he cried out and to the Lord, fire came from heaven and consumed the sacrifice. So we see that he had a very impressive resume. The people fell on their face, shouting, "The Lord, he is God, and the Lord, he is God." Elijah ordered the people to slay the 850 false prophets. They died that day. Elijah prayed, and rain fell on Israel after 3.5 years. Elijah, Jezebel was furious at the loss of her prophets. However, and she swore to kill Elijah. Afraid, Elijah ran to the wilderness and sat under the juniper tree. And in his despair, he asked God to take his life. Instead, the prophet slept, and the angel brought him food and strengthened Elijah. Elijah went 40 days and 40 nights to Mount Horeb, where God appeared to him in a whisper. God ordered Elijah to anoint his successor, Elijah, whom he found plowing with 12 yokes of oxen. Elijah killed the animals for the sacrifice and followed his master. Elijah went on to prophesy the death of Elijah and Jezebel. Like Enoch, Elijah did not die. God sent chariots and horses of fire and took Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind while Elijah stood watching. So we find that this man was a great man of God. But we find here in the book of Kings, we find him in chapter 19, in verse number 9. We find him now despair. We find him now not knowing what to do. He's having a panic attack. He's in a state of depression and oppression. He don't want to face Jezebel. When Jezebel said, "I'm going to take your life," he ran. This is the same man that called fire from heaven. This is the same man that caused it not to rain for 3 years. This is the same man that told the king that you're going to die and the dogs is going to lick your blood. This is the same man that the people feared and asked him, "Are you for us or are you against us?" The same one, but now he feels fear. But fear is not of God. Do you ever find yourself in the grips of despair? Does fear ever possess you? Do you ever have doubt? Do you ever experience loneliness and feeling that nobody understands? Do you ever feel the end that you're at the end of your rope? This is all, as Popeye used to say, "This is all I can stand, because I can't stand no more." Amen. Or have you ever been there? Do you ever go to sleep and wish that you need not even wake up? Because things are so desperate. This is the way he felt. So we know what God was able to do, but God began to deal with him. God began to strengthen him, even in the midst. But the Lord asked him, "What are you doing here?" So when it comes to us, sometimes we feel like, "Lord, I can't go another step of the way." And God is saying, "Well, what are you doing here? What are you doing? Not in a physical place, but what are you doing in this spiritual place, in this mental place? What are you doing here after all that I have done for you? What are you doing here?" Sometimes we have to go back and draw on the resume of God in our lives. We have to go back and determine, "Lord, you have never failed me. Even when it looked like you didn't answer my prayer, it was the best thing that you could have done. It's not giving me what I was asking you for." Have you ever been there? At the end, you say, "Oh, Lord, thank you for not doing what I asked you to do. You know, I know, Lord, that you was looking out for my good." So we see despair. He was suddenly gripped by fear and alarm. And the question is asked, is this that courageous man that we see in Kings 18, 17, and 18 and 40? Is this the same man which of the king in chapter 19 speaks, Elijah running for his life in fear, is a dreadful thing which we have all experienced in some measure. We've all been there. We've all been fear of the uncertain. We've all had fear of the unknown. We didn't understand what God was doing and what our next move was and where the Lord was going to take us next. And we all had fear. But God said, "You know, what are you doing here? Haven't I always looked out for you? Haven't I always been there for you? Even when you call me, haven't I always listened? Haven't I always encouraged you and raised you up? Even in this pandemic, God is saying not to fear, not to fear. Be concerned and be cautious, But don't fear. Because fear is not of him. It's not of him. He's saying, you know, lean back and have confidence in me. And I will take you through and I will guide you and I will lead you. And I will be a shield over you. So my question today is, what are you doing here? So you lost your job. So now you're in a panic attack. But God said, I gave you that job. Not only did I give you the job, I gave you means to get there. I gave you health every morning to rise up and go to the place. I will give you another job. What's a job to God but a drop in the bucket? So you say, well, I don't know what I'm going to do about babysitting and my children and all of that. What is that to God? Where one closed, another one opens up. God is in control. So I want to encourage you today that you will hold on to God's unchanging hand. That when fear comes, you ask yourself, well, I'm not going to stay here. I'm moving on out of here. That you tell yourself, Lord, I know that you reign. And I'm going to celebrate you. You know, I think sometimes we don't celebrate God enough. We say it, but we don't do it. I'm going to praise the Lord, but do you do it? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Do you bless his name? Do you do it? I know sometimes it might look foolish, it might look silly, but we ought to bless his name. God bless you today. May heaven ever smile upon you. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Amen. Have a safe holiday. Eat all you can. Just eat the right things. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah.